In this video, we'll be looking at our DTM or Distributed Test Manager tool. We'll be specifically looking at ICCP or TASE2 client and server functionality. So we're going to start from a blank workspace and build everything up, but just know that we do have sample workspaces, including this ICCP unidirectional server and client built up for you automatically when you download our DTM tool. So let's go ahead and start from scratch and let's create some devices. So I'm going to go to the new workspace here, right click, add, and we have ICCP. When we get in here, by default we have bidirectional selected. I'm going to go ahead and create a client and server pair just to show how dataset transfer sets work and how that pairing works between client and server, but you can also do bidirectional and configure it all at once if you're going to be having two pairs of bidirectional. So I'm going to go ahead and click server and start there. I'll name this my ICCP server. And then I'll give it an address. 0.0.0 just means use anything I have, but I'm going to specifically say it's at 10.10.10.102. If you have exported an object model previously, you can import that here, or you can start from an empty model. I'll do an empty model just so I can show you how to create more additional points. And by default, the listening port is 102. That's obviously configurable, but you want to stick to the standard, you want to do 102. I'll go ahead and click OK. And this device will start up. Now while it's starting up, I'll need to explain, we need to make changes to the model while the server is offline. So to do that, you right click down here at the bottom and you go to manage and click stop. And that will stop the model and the server from running. So now if I do a show model, we'll have access to the model and you'll be able to interact with it and add things. For example, I could go to the ICC1 domain here and do add a new node, and I have access to all the different node types here. So discretes and reals, time tags, extended, things like that. I'll do a real queue and I'll say my new real queue as the name, and you can create a single one or multiple. So I can come in here and say do 5. Now that I've done that, all of those points have been added and you can interact with them in any way you'd like, including the value and the flags. You can even come into the data sets and do add a data set and select anything within the model of this server to be included in this data set. So I'll say my server created data set as the name, and I'll pick the first, say, 3 of those real queues I created. So I'll go ahead and hit OK. That'll create a data set, and I can create some transfer sets. I'm going to create 2 transfer sets through this process, so that way the client will have multiple things to interact with. So the first one I'll say is data set transfer set 1. And I'm not going to configure anything special here, but you do have configuration options. And then I will also come in here and do data set transfer set number 2. So now that I've added the new data, data set, and then 2 different data set transfer sets, I'm going to go ahead and right click, manage, and start back up this server. Now that it's online, we need to have a client connect to it. So you can either go to your client tool and connect up to this remotely, or you can create a simulated one within DTM. To do that, you follow the same process. You right click, add ICCP, and we'll do a client this time. I will name this my client ICCP device. I'm going to give it the IP address of 0.0.0.106, but I know the server address is 10.10.10.102, and obviously previously I meant 10.10.10.106. If you have the model like you exported, this is where you could provide that, or we have a built-in, maybe not officially supported functionality of discovery that will allow you to gather the model just by connecting up to the server. I'll have initiate on start, so that way they'll automatically connect. So if I hit OK, it'll give you a little warning about discovery. I'll go ahead and say that's all right. And once the client is brought up, since I had initiate on start, it went ahead and initiated. So I'm going to go to the client now, and I'm going to go ahead and do show model. And I'm going to put these side by side. So I'll just grab this tab and pull it up, drag it over, and highlight that area and put it there. So now I can navigate into that ICC1 domain that we were looking at, and we can see all my real queues that I added. We can even see the data set here. But If you did not create a dataset or your server does not have a dataset, you can always right-click and create a dynamic dataset. So for this dynamic dataset, I'll go ahead and select all the real queues, and I'll name this client created dataset. You can, of course, include timestamps and names and any of these other settings up here. You can select data from other areas in the model, but I'll just do the ones I've created so far. I'll hit OK. Then you can come into the dataset transfer set and right-click and say Get Next Available. That will go ahead and grab the dataset transfer set, and then you can select the dataset that you want to be part of it. So I could select the server-created dataset or the client-created. I'll do the client-created one for now. And then, of course, you have the settings that you can set up. Obviously, I want it on object changes or timeouts or whatnot. You can select all of that here. So I'll go ahead and do that. Now we have reserved it. You can right-click it to edit it or enable it or just read. I'm going to enable it. And that will allow you to actually get access to this. So now that we have it enabled, if I go back over to my server here and change the values to say 100, we'll come down here and maybe do 200, right? We're just changing data on this point. I can come down into this report viewer at the bottom, which you can get by going into views and then IEC 61850/ICCP reports. And then we can see these reports coming across the line and see what values were inside of them. You can even multi-select them and see what changed from report to report. So if I change this 100 again to say 500, and maybe this quality here, now that I can select all of these reports, we can see what values have actually changed in between all of the reports coming across the line. You have access to other functionality as well, such as going and right-clicking in the client and just performing reads, or even going over to the client, right-clicking, and doing commands, such as read, writes, and controls. And if you need data to change in a more cyclical manner rather than manually going into the model and changing it, you do have the ability to right-click and do data changes, including CSV file, playback, and auto data changes. Hopefully this will help you get started using ICCP or TASE2 in DTM. And if you need more information on DTM, there are plenty of other training videos on our YouTube channel and our website. Thank you for watching.